Welcome back. Let's do 3D references in Excel today. What I've got here is a sheet, a workbook that has four quarters. And what I want to do is pull the sales rep number for each of the four regions that I've got and put it in this year-end summary. So the way I'll do this is starting with the sum function, equals sum. When I'm doing the autocomplete like this, use the tab key or just double click it on the list and it will fill in the cell. And then I'm going to start with the first sheet that I want to bring in, quarter one. Holding the shift key, I'm going to grab quarter four. That's going to get me every instance of North for Jones on all four quarters. And then I click the actual cell that I want. There it is, and I enter it into the cell. Now you'll see there what it did, equals sum, and then you've got quarter one, colon, quarter four. So the colon means through, just like a regular range. This is a range of sheets. And then you see the little single quote on either end. That's because I have spaces in my, my sheet names there. It's followed by an exclamation point and then the actual cell reference. I'll point out to you, a lot of times this comes in as an absolute reference. And if you get an absolute reference like that and you fill it down, you would have to change each of those to the correct row, right? Because an absolute reference stays stuck on whatever you've copied it from. Now let's just do it again to review. So if I do equals sum, I select the function I want, and then I go ahead and click quarter one, hold shift, click quarter four, and then I click on the cell I want. That's it. Now, just checking here, it noticed that I had changed this earlier from an absolute to a relative reference. So it's giving me the relative reference now, which is perfect. It copies, and it copies relative to its new location. So you'll see each of those came in correctly. That is it. That's a 3D reference through sheets that are set up identical.